One of the make or break issues when considering direct-to-film printing is the regular maintenance. Depending on what YouTube video you may have just watched, you may have heard that it's terrible, or maybe even that it's no big deal. Today, we're pulling back the curtain on DTF printer maintenance, sharing why regular maintenance is so important, and showing the general steps involved. To say that regular maintenance keeps your DTF printer running smoothly is correct, but it's also an understatement. The success of your direct-to-film operation literally hangs on regular printer maintenance. Thankfully, these maintenance procedures are usually pretty straightforward, simple, and only take a few minutes. So much importance is placed on maintenance because of the consequences when neglected. In order to keep the transfers thin and light while maintaining as much resolution and color depth as possible, DTF printers use a water-based ink system. This water-based property of DTF ink is a big part of what makes it so awesome. But this property is also what brings the biggest challenges to the process. When the water in the ink evaporates, the pigment and other chemicals in the ink dry up and solidify. This is where the problem lies. If the ink dries on the printhead, the nozzles will clog and cause misprints. If the ink dries on your capping station or wiper blade, this could actually damage the printhead as it passes over. Depending on your printer, a replacement printhead can cost anywhere from a few hundred to well over $1,000. White DTF ink is special and must be circulated regularly in order to keep the titanium dioxide distributed throughout the liquid solution. If not, it will separate and settle, causing your white ink to print very thin and lackluster. So all of this sounds pretty scary, right? Well, it doesn't have to be. Fortunately, it's relatively easy to avoid all of these problems. You just have to follow the simple regular maintenance procedures, which will vary depending on your machine. Be sure you're following the specific instructions included with your model of direct-to-film printer, as the procedures shown in this video are only meant to provide a general overview. The biggest element to regular maintenance focuses on keeping your nozzles clear. There are a few steps to this. First, you'll want to get your swab and cleaning solution and clean excess ink on the wiper blade, capping station, and around the printhead. This is usually followed by a head cleaning. A nozzle check will inform you on the status of your printhead and whether or not another head cleaning is required. Most printers will require that you wet cap the machine at the end of the day or week. Wet capping simply requires you to squirt a few drops of cleaning solution on the capping station. This whole procedure only takes a few minutes and when done properly will save you significant time, money, and stress. At Heat Press Nation, we only carry printers with automatic white ink circulation systems. While you don't have to worry about stirring your white ink that's in the printer, you will want to give your ink bottles a shake every day. Several of our printers perform automatic head cleanings every few hours around the clock and should be left on at all times. While this doesn't replace the need for daily maintenance, it does provide a little more safety for your printer should you forget and accidentally skip a day. To get the most from your adhesive powder, you'll want to return all of your leftover powder back into the sealed package at the end of the day. If left out, it could possibly absorb moisture from the air and solidify into small stone-like pieces. In addition to head cleanings, there are a few other regular maintenance procedures that you'll want to follow. Again, these are general guidelines. Be sure to refer to your machine's specific maintenance instructions and schedule. At the end of the work week, you should empty your waste collection unit, clean the print bed, which is the area your media and printhead pass over, and clean your pinch rollers. Cleaning the pinch rollers also requires you to reload and realign your media, which ensures it's always feeding straight. On a monthly or as needed basis, you will also want to replace the filters on your fume extractor and apply some lubricant to the metal track that the print carriage runs on. Lastly, there are two things I want to mention that don't quite fall under maintenance, but are more maintenance adjacent. First, using recommended high quality supplies like film and ink will help ensure you get the best use and lifespan from your DTF printer. Second, do not underestimate the power of humidity. Operating range does vary between machines, but the ideal level for most DTF printers is around 50% humidity. There are usually two different reactions to learning about the DTF printer maintenance. The first is, wow, DTF printers require all that work? And that usually comes from folks whose needs don't align with the value that DTF provides. But many times, the reaction is more along the lines of, wow, that's all? When you consider the quality of the product, benefits of the process, and profitability overall, you'll realize that regular maintenance is completely worth it. No other system is going to produce transfers like DTF. Durable, colorful, detailed, and on demand. While this video is only a general representation of DTF maintenance, our hope is that by pulling back the curtain on the full process, you'll be able to decide for yourself whether or not DTF is right for you. And if you're like thousands of other print shops across the world who do see the value in direct-to-film printing, head on over to heatpressnation.com or give our sales team a call at 800-215-0894 to order your own DTF printer package. For more DTF and other heat transfer content, be sure to subscribe to our channel and hit that like button while you're at it.